Here, the reason behind all these experiences, what you have seen, is only due to evaporation. So this video is all about evaporation. So in this video, we will be learning the reason, finding the reason behind all these experiences. So this video is going to be very, very interesting and knowledgeable. So watch till the end of this video. And if not subscribe this channel, then subscribe this channel and press bell icon so that you will be notified whenever I upload a new video. So let us start today's session. Dear students, as far as evaporation is concerned, it is one of the most important topic that has to be understood clearly. Not only for 9th standard, when you go higher standard, there also it will help you to solve various problems. So let us understand this evaporation process in detail. Students, you know that when heat is given to a substance, if it is a solid substance, it can change into liquid state. If heat is given to a liquid substance, then liquid goes into gaseous phase. Right, so change in state we can see if temperature or heat is supplied to a substance. If heat is given to a liquid, then liquid can go into another phase, that is gaseous phase. When liquid changes its state into gaseous state, this process we call it as boiling. And the boiling of a liquid takes place at a certain temperature. The temperature at which a liquid changes into gas, we call it as boiling point. Boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius, which means when heat of 100 degrees Celsius is given to water, or when the temperature of the water reaches 100 degrees Celsius, then water will no more become liquid, it goes into gaseous phase. And this temperature is known as boiling point of water. So we can say that boiling is a process in which a liquid changes into gas at its boiling point. Let us understand the evaporation process. Evaporation is also a process in which a liquid changes into gaseous phase. Then what is boiling? Boiling also liquid changes into gaseous phase. The difference between boiling and evaporation is evaporation takes place at any temperature below its boiling point, whereas boiling takes place exactly at its boiling point, right? Now let us take an example to understand the evaporation process. When a wet cloth is spread widely on the sunlight or on exposed, when it is exposed to air, then after some time you can see very well that the clothes get dried up. What do you think? The atmosphere provides 100 degrees Celsius to the water present in the cloth, or the sunlight provides enough heat to boil it? No, children, here neither the atmosphere nor the sunlight provides 100 degrees Celsius. Here the water present in the cloth goes into the gaseous phase below its boiling point. How could this possible? We know that water changes into gaseous phase when it reaches 100 degrees Celsius, right? Now the point to be noted, and here you have to understand the evaporation process very clearly. Let us understand the difference between boiling and evaporation. Here the boiling process is a bulk phenomena, whereas evaporation is surface phenomena. What is this bulk phenomena actually? Here you see a beaker containing some water. If heat is supplied to the container, then what happens? The water which is present at the bottom of the beaker, that gets heated up, and that water molecule goes up, and the water molecules which are at the surface, that water molecule goes down, and that particles get heated up. This way entire water gets heated up, and finally when all the particles are heated to a range, when the water molecules get 100 degrees Celsius, then it starts vaporizing. So the water changes into vapor. Here the formation of water vapor, that is the gaseous state, forms only after all the water molecules are heated up to 100 degrees Celsius. You might have studied in the lower classes that the boiling of water takes place by means of convection. What is this convection? When heat is supplied to the beaker, the water molecules which are there at the bottom, that particles get heated up. Once they receive heat, that particles go above, and the colder molecules which are at the surface of the water, that particles go down. This way whole water molecules get heated up. So we can say that boiling is a bulk phenomena, whereas the evaporation is a surface phenomena. Here what happens, when you keep this beaker exposed to the air, then the Particles which are above the surface of the water, they are continuously in contact with the atmosphere. Here the water molecules get energy from the surrounding. The energy is sufficient enough to break the bond between the particles which are there at the top surface of the water molecules and below the water molecules. Once they get sufficient energy, then they break the bond between the particles and they escape from the surface. So we can say that evaporation is a surface phenomena. Let us now understand what are the various factors on which the evaporation of liquid depends upon. The first factor on which the evaporation depends is temperature. What will happen if we increase the temperature? Now we know that evaporation is a surface phenomena and the particles which are there at the surface, they get energy from the surroundings, right? Now, if we heat the substance, then naturally we are increasing the temperature of the substance, and thereby when we supply heat, then it will get more kinetic energy. When the particles get more kinetic energy, then the rate of evaporation will increase. So, by increasing temperature, the evaporation process will also increase. Let us take an example. Two clothes we have, identical clothes we have taken, and both are wet. One is dried under sunlight, one is under shady place. Which one will dry faster? Obviously, the cloth which is exposed under sunlight, that will dry up very quickly. Why? Because their sunlight increases the kinetic energy of the particles. Since the kinetic energy is more, than the rate of evaporation will be higher, so they dry up faster. Understood, children? So, increase in temperature increases the rate of evaporation. The second factor on which evaporation of liquid depends is surface area. Let us take an example. From this example, you will come to know whether increasing surface area will increase the rate of evaporation or decreasing surface area will increase the rate of evaporation. Now, let us take an example. Here we have two clothes. One is for drying these clothes, what I am going to do is, first cloth is spread apart and another one is without spreading, I just hanged in the string. Which one will dry faster? You are very much familiar with such type of experiences, right? The cloth which is spread apart, that will be dried faster. Why? Here, when we spread the cloth wider, then we are increasing the surface area. When the surface area is increased, we know that evaporation is a surface phenomena. If the water molecules get more surface, then it has got more surface area, so the escaping tendency of water molecules will be more. If it gets more surface area, then more water molecules will get evaporated. So, the rate of evaporation will increase if the surface area is more. Similar other kind of experience you will have. If water is spilled over some on the floor, in that case, what will you do? There you start mopping. Mopping means you are just spreading the water molecules, right? When you increase the surface area, then the rate of evaporation will increase. As a result of this, the spilled over water on the surface of the floor gets dried up quickly. So, such kind of experience you are already having, right? The science has to be applied in this. What is that science? Their surface area comes into play. When we increase the surface area, then the rate of evaporation will increase. The third factor is humidity. Let us understand how humidity affects the rate of evaporation. Firstly, we should know what is humidity, right? Humidity is the presence of moisture or the tiny water droplets in the atmosphere. If more water is there in the atmosphere, we call it as more humid, or humidity is more. If less water content is there in the atmosphere, we call it as less humid. And we know that during evaporation process, water droplets changes into gas, that is water vapor, and they go into the atmosphere. Now, if it is more humid condition, then in that case, the atmosphere is already with some water droplets, right? Since it is more humid condition. In such case, what happens? The evaporation process will be less, because if the water droplet changes into water vapor, then where will the water molecule go? There is no space, because the space is already occupied by some water droplet. Since it is a humid condition, so the rate of evaporation will be less in case of humid condition. If the humidity is less, then we can expect more spaces in the atmosphere for the gases, water vapor, to be accommodated. In less humid condition, the rate of evaporation will be more, since more space is available in the atmosphere so that the water can evaporate and goes into water vapor, and the vapors can go into the spaces available in the atmosphere. What is it, children? Now we see the fourth factor on which the evaporation depends. Let us take an example. We have two identical wet clothes and they are spread apart and hanged on a string. One cloth is having enough wind flow and another is less wind flow. Which cloth will dry faster? Obviously, the cloth which has got more wind. Now, here the role of wind, that has to be understood. Here, when you wind speed is more, in that case what happens? When wind is blowing during evaporation, the water droplets just escape from the surface of the cloth, right? When they escape from the surface of the cloth, if the wind comes, the wind blows out the water vapor and there once again space is created. So the evaporated water molecules, once again it can escape. So the tendency or the rate of evaporation will be more if more space is available. This space is created by blowing wind. That is why the clothes during rainy seasons and all, we usually dry our clothes under the fan. When the fan is put on, then the speed of the wind will be more. In that case, the rate of evaporation will also be more. Got it, children? So altogether, we can say that the rate of evaporation is very well affected by temperature, surface area, humidity, and wind speed. So in order to increase the rate of evaporation, we should increase the temperature, surface area, and wind speed, thereby decreasing the humidity. Got it, children? So hope you found this video useful. If so, then hit the like button. If not, subscribe this channel and press bell icon so that you will be notified whenever I upload a new video. See you all on another day with a new video. Till then, take good care of yourself. Bye.